How's the tune?
Turns very nicely. It handles, really handles like it's just a van almost, you know, a minivan. Very firm.
This should be one of the peppiest RVs that we have on the market with this EcoBoost Ford engine and the lighter weight chassis. It really runs well. When we get on the highway, you'll see it really, really takes off.
Even just there, I just touched the gas and it really responded right away.
We are Tavan
and David.
This is our journey in finding
the RV
for us.
The goal of this channel is to share our journey with you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, here we are. David. My name's Rick. We're here at Fritz RV.
As soon as David's ready, we'll blast off.
I know, it's all this technology. We're good to go.
Good to go.
We're good to go.
You know.
So, how's the seat?
Seat's very comfortable.
Does it adjust forward,
well, not sure
up and down,
adjusts.
Or no?
In between back. Your legs in the front.
Right, so I'm sliding forward and back right here.
Yeah.
And is there any pitch control on this?
There is. It's,
yeah, I got it.
You found it. Good.
Yep. There you go.
And then the other, I believe, is a lumbar support.
Yes, mm-hmm. right down here.
Yeah, the knob.
This guy.
Okay.
And you have your armrest, of course, right. If you want.
Yeah.
Some people like that, some don't.
Yes, right, the armrest. There you go. Good navigation system there.
Yep.
Drive.
Brakes off.
And brakes off. Let's go.
Let's go.
How you been, Rick?
I've been doing well. We've been
busy for you?
Yeah, we've been extremely busy. Yeah, business has been good. We've been fortunate.
I'm turning left here?
Yes.
How's the tune?
Turns very nicely. It handles like it's just a van almost, you know, a minivan. Very firm.
This should be one of the peppiest RVs that we have on the market with this EcoBoost Ford engine and the lighter weight chassis. It really runs well. When we get on the highway, you'll see it really, really takes off.
Even just there, I just touched the gas and it really responded right away. Okay.
So you're going to make a right here at this light.
Okay.
And get on to 309 North.
So have you been having a lot of interest on tour?
We have. It seems like it's off to a good start. We've sold a few already. We have a few more on order.
Mm-hmm.
And now the supply's starting to roll. I think it's going to turn out to be a real, real popular seller for us.
Mm-hmm. It might take over the Lexor.
Yeah, perhaps.
Think?
I mean, there's a market for both, I guess. But
yeah.
Ford really seems to hit the sweet spot in the price and the size and the performance. I think it's in some ways a little nicer than the Lexor.
Yeah.
Although that's a popular model as well.
Right. How was it getting on the highway?
No problems whatsoever. Right on.
Right on.
Got on with authority.
Okay.
When we get past this next exit, keep going straight, and there's a big hill.
Yeah.
That'll be a good test to give it a little fuel and see how it climbs. Plus, we'll get past this construction.
Yeah. Yes, it is very responsive.
Yeah.
Step on the gas like that, you can feel we're kind of surging forward.
Truck ahead of us is the exits on the right. another left and we'll just come down the other side of the highway.
All right.
Go right back the way we came.
How does it feel compared to 2.2, the drive?
They feel very similar. I think this maybe is a little peppier.
Uh-huh. It's the same engine,
yeah.
So it's a little lighter weight. You'd have to figure it'd be a little more responsive.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Although, like you said, they both drive really well.
Yes. Oh, yes. It was 2.2 was not suffering in any way from that. It was very responsive as well.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I really like the visibility with the windows cut really low like this.
Mm-hmm.
Is that getting off here, Rick, or the next one?
You can go to the next one.
Gotcha.
We'll just get off at the Souderton exit.
You got it.
Anything else you want to tell us about Ontour 2.2?
Well,
this is 2.0. Yeah.
2.0. Well, it's similar in most ways to the 2.2 that we test drove last time you were down. It's a little smaller, of course, a little more compact. Same Ford drivetrain, the same Pleasure Wave build quality.
Mm-hmm.
We're excited the fact that they're making everything standard in these models. There's no options. It comes standard with the screens and the compressor refrigerator. All the features are included. So there's the only choices the customer has to make is the colors, whether they want the light natural maple like this one here we're in, or the mocha, which is a darker stained wood. And then you get a choice of your countertops or your leather seats, your ultra leather seats. But apart from that, it's very easy and it's a complete package. Some of these brands, you know, they have a lower price, but then you have to add everything at extra cost. So it makes this a better value, I think, in most ways. So if you get off here, David, we're going to make a left at the stop sign.
All right.
And then you should recognize we're right on the street here.
Now, I noticed that there's very little interior rattling going on today. The last time we test drove, nothing had really been secured, and it was...
Yeah, and you know what it turned out? I contacted Pleasure Way.
Yeah.
And the microwave on the 2.2 video was defective. The door was actually loose in some way.
Oh, wow.
And they said rather than repair it, they just sent us a new microwave and we installed that. And I thought it was the contents of the microwave, which was part of it, but even after we removed the tray, it still had a noisy door. And so we remedied that by just replacing it. And because typically the Pleasure Ways are the quietest ride in Class Bs on the market.
Because I really didn't hear any rattling at all. Maybe a little data over there, but not from, you know, the microwave.
Yeah, I mean,
area.
It's... There is a lot of stuff in here, so you're going to hear some noise,
a little bit,
but
yeah.
Certainly not like a lot of the brands. The biggest source of rattles once you buy one of these is your own stuff.
Yeah.
So
exactly.
How you pack it goes a long way to keeping it quiet.
Yeah.
People have all kinds of tricks to try to... pad things so they stay quiet when you're on the road. So you're gonna make a right here and then the store's on the left.
Second entrance? Or?
Either one, whatever one looks good to you.
Thank you.
overhang a little bit,
yeah,
you could get in even a little bit tighter.
Oh yeah. Perfect. No problem at all. Parking,
no problem
yeah.
at all, no.
Yeah. Regular parking.
Of course, one of the huge advantages of that model is
yeah.
the maneuverability. You can access just about anywhere.
Right. Yeah. Very nice.
Yep. You want to pull the other one down next
yeah.
to it? Take
can,
a look?
Yeah, that would
Let
be
go
great.
The keys.
Okay. Okay, David, he's going to pull the 2.2.